hear what Elder Isaac said? That is what they call a listening ear. You know, some people can be here for 10 years, they will not be able to speak like him. I'm not talking about the correctness of the English he spoke. I'm talking about the language of the Spirit with which he spoke. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
First of all, you have to have a humble and a contrite spirit to receive from God. The first people that fall when Christ appears are the leaders, those who are filled with knowledge. You know Paul had knowledge?
Yes.
You know Paul's knowledge was the highest level of knowledge at that time?
Yes.
Okay. He had a PhD in theology and all that kind of stuff. And before you speak, he tells you that it is written in this place. It is written in the book of this, chapter that. That was Paul for you. But you know what he called that at the end of the day? He said it was like trash. Like garbage. I don't want to use the exact language because it's quite deep. But he said that it is like trash. That knowledge he had. Deep knowledge. All he can do is to make you what? Puffed up. Puffed what?
Puffed up.
That I know. So when the Spirit now comes to talk to you, you cannot hear. You know what Jesus told them? He said, because you say you see. That's, he's talking to the people who think they know. Because you say you see, you remain in your
ignorance.
Blindness and your ignorance, and he left on and he moved on. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
What am I trying to say? Let us be eager to speak less and listen more. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
All of us, let it be a lesson to us to first of all listen properly. You shall know the truth, and the truth will set you free. What is the truth? Christ in you is the truth. I am the way, the truth, and the life. Well, if you want to look at Jesus in the sky as the light and the way, the truth, or you want to look at the historical Jesus as the way, the truth, and the light, you have put a barrier between you. God's kingdom. God is not doing anything to you. He has already given you. It's either you receive it or you reject it. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Listen. You shall know who you are. And when you know who you are, your fears are gone. Your poverty is abolished. Your anxiety is gone forever. Your bondage to sin is gone forever, because the Son of God cannot sin.
Hallelujah.
So we are looking through the glass mirror today, and we are seeing Christ. Anytime we come here, we preach Christ. We don't preach another thing. We preach Christ. We look at the mirror. Hallelujah. Just look at him. That's all. And see the way you are. As you look through the mirror, you are seeing yourself in the image of Christ. And we are now conformed back into that image. That is our calling. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You shall know the truth, and the truth will set you free. This is the, what they call the key of David. Il chiavi di Davide. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You begin to, if you look at me, you might see me as a man who is well dressed, who is this, who is that, but you don't know where I am. You don't know what I'm seeing. You can't even see me. You don't know me. You're only seeing the outer. And you don't know from where I'm speaking. You don't know how, you don't know what there are certain things at times you cannot explain to men. You cannot. Amen.
Amen.
But it's by listening. Hallelujah. Amen. Listening, praise God. It's not by crowds. Because God has told me So talk yourself in and keep yourself silent, quiet. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's not by crowds. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, I like an article I read once. It says, when you see too many crowds, there's something wrong. If the crowds didn't gather with Jesus, why should they gather somewhere else now? Somebody said, but multitudes follow Jesus. Multitudes did not follow Jesus. The multitudes that followed Jesus were hearing in parables. Because when Jesus Christ spoke to the multitudes, all they were hearing was what?
Parables.
The miracles were parables. The healing of the lame, of the blind were what? Parables. You can have a physical eyesight and still be blind. You can be healed of your lameness but still be lame. We're talking of things that are real and eternal. These things were what? Parables. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He raised the dead from the, he raised those who were dead. He raised them out of their grave. That was a parable. Aren't they dead today again?
No,
it was only a parable. He was showing us the mystery of the resurrection, of the turning back to yourself. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God. So the multitudes that were shouting, oh, he's healed, oh, and they were all, you know when Lazarus came out of the grave, you know all of them, say, oh, this is Son of God. Did they come back to follow Jesus?
No.
They did not. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Because if they were to come to Jesus, all they'll be hearing is Christ in you. And they say, this one is not enough for them. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. That's all they'll be hearing. So the multitudes were seeing parables. Today, people gather in multitudes to listen to what? Parables. Not the real thing. What is the real thing? Your eternal, incorruptible self. That is the real thing. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.